Hey everyone, in this tutorial we're going to be looking at how you can import your Cartoon Animator scene into Blender to enhance and modify it in various ways. If you're looking for content, you can always find lots of cool stuff in the content store. Everything from characters to props, accessories, scenes, and more can be found here for all Reallusion products, both 2D and 3D. Let's first do some simple scene setup in Cartoon Animator. This scene has already been set up with a number of layers that you can see here in 3D mode. These can all be moved around to various points to emphasize a parallax effect, which we'll use later. If I bring in this bonfire prop, I can move it back and forth on the Z-axis to be closer or further away from the camera. After that, it's important to set the playback range of the project to determine how long it will play for. In order to animate the bonfire, I can go into the sprite editor and randomly choose a different sprite from the library at each frame to simulate a crackling fire. Do a few frames of this, and then you can simply copy and paste a group of the keyframes to fill up the timeline faster. Let's throw our first character in next, and resize him to fit the rest of the scene. If you want to focus on one element in your scene, you can use the Isolate Selection feature in order to get rid of all the other stuff. From there, I'm going to apply a few motion templates to the character so it looks like he's leaning over the fire. After you apply a motion, you can always modify it more with the Motion Key Editor. In this case, I'm locking the character's feet so that they don't move, and then modifying the head and upper chest positions at various points in the timeline so it looks like he's intermittently tilting forward a bit more. You can also add sprite accessories to different body parts as well. In this case, I'm taking the character into Composer mode and then adding a small flame to his hand sprite. Once this is done, I can reposition it on the machine thing on his arm and repeat the same process with the sprite library to simulate a flickering flame. After he takes the machine away from the flame, then I can also set an opacity key, and a few frames later, take it down to zero, in order to simulate the effect of a flame going out. Let's bring another character in and repeat the process that we used of the previous one, only this time, we'll use a different seated motion. Again, you can use the Isolate Selection feature to focus on an object or character you're working with. Once that's done, then you can create a simple camera animation to pan through the scene and get a result like this. Cartoon Animator has some export features that make it easier to export projects to other software. In this case, I'm selecting a transparent PNG export from the render settings, making sure to select Export into Separate Files and Fit to Object Size, and select the proper range. Once the export is finished, you'll find separate folders for audio, sequence image, and single image folders. Objects that aren't animated will naturally just have a single image, since they don't need to move. Let's move to Blender now. The first thing we want to do to prepare is to open the Preferences, go to the Add-ons tab, and search for the Import Images as Planes add-on in order to enable it. Then let's go up to the File menu and select the Import Images as Planes item in order to get our first image in. To adjust the position, you can use the R hotkey for rotate and set it at a 90 degree angle to the ground plane. Let's go into the Shading tab in order to fine-tune the image appearance for Blender. Here, the main thing that you want to do is disconnect the Alpha node, then in the Object Settings, change the Blend mode to Alpha Clip. Let's proceed to change your object mode to edit mode, and then find the knife tool in the left toolbar in order to trim the object. The purpose here is to extrude a 3D object from this 2D plane, so we need to select them all, and then select Dissolve Faces. Now we have an object that's ready to extrude, so I'm going to select all of the faces that I need and use Extrude Region from the left menu. I'll then click and drag to extrude in the direction that I want. The only things not extruding are the light and poster face. The next step is to go into object mode and duplicate the prop, then return to edit mode and remove everything on the second prop, aside from the poster face, by deleting all of the extraneous vertices. From there, I'll select the poster face, go into shading mode, and create a glow effect. To do this, I'll first delete the principled BDSF node, and then bring in one for brightness and contrast, and also one for emission, and connect them. This will allow me to adjust the brightness and contrast, as well as the emissive power of the plane. We also want to ensure that we enable the bloom checkbox to emphasize the glow. Once that's enabled, then the emissive node in the object shader will be able to influence the glow strength, which you can tweak with contrast for a clearer sun. To create 3D objects from 2D planes, you basically want to use this same step for each object in your scene. Once you're done, you'll have a 3D scene that you can navigate freely from different perspectives. Let's look next at bringing in the animated fire. We'll start by importing it in just like the other objects, being sure to select the first frame of your image sequence. After it's in position, then we need to go into the shading tab again and ensure that our PNG node is set to image sequence, and specify the number of frames, which corresponds with the number of images we exported. We can then play back to see the 2D result in our viewport. It looks a bit flat, so let's make it glow in a slightly different way. We're still going to set the blend mode and shadow mode to alpha clip, but this time our shader nodes will be slightly different. We're still going to add our brightness, contrast, and emission nodes, but this time we're also going to bring in a mix shader node and connect that before the final material output. This will allow us to tweak the values of all the nodes, in addition to determining how they are mixed at the end, which gives more control over the final material output. The final result will be a nice, warm, glowing animated fire. We can then resize it and position it in place. I'm going to bring in a character next. Essentially, the process is the same as the animated fire that we brought in. You'll want to choose the first frame of the image sequence, resize it and reposition it, and then change the blend and shadow modes to alpha clip and add an emission and mix shader node. In this case, we're not going to worry about the brightness and contrast, and instead only add an emissive node in order to brighten up the character, since he looks a little faded out here. Just connect the nodes like you see here, tweak to your preference, and you're good to go. Here we've repeated the same process for the other character now, and we're going to move on to the lighting. Let's go up and toggle the viewport shading mode on, and you'll see the entire scene go dark, except for the items that have a glow or emission assigned to their material shaders. Let's go up to the Add drop-down menu to choose a point light, and bring it forward to the same position of our fire. Once we do that, we can go to the Properties, and let there be light by bringing up the power level. We can also change the color tint to something a little warmer to reflect the warmth of the fire. From there, let's duplicate that light and bring the copy a little further back in the timeline, then give it a colder color to reflect the glow of the signs in the background. We can then duplicate that light and move it further back to light up the furthest background plane, which will act as sort of a third layer to bring in more depth to our scene. Set the lighting appropriately to give a subtle yet noticeable addition to the scene. If we pan left and right, we can see the 3D parallax effect taking place. Finally, let's get to the camera. We can go to that same Add menu to find a camera, and then proceed to set up a separate window for user and camera perspective. From there, I can manually adjust the position of the camera at different points in the timeline to create an animation that will take us from focusing on the background to zooming out a bit and panning through the scene to maximize the parallax effect. The full 3D production environment in Blender really allows you a lot of freedom to enhance your Cartoon Animator scenes, and with all the output options, it's easier than ever to accomplish. Thanks for watching this tutorial, guys. Hopefully you learned a lot, and be sure to check out our forums at forum.reallusion.com. I'll see you in the next video.